Good day, folks. Thank you so much for joining us today. We have with us Nasir Mahmood. He is a PhD working in the area of data science. And without having me to introduce him, we'll just get started by him telling us a little bit about himself first. So, Nasir, if you can get started by telling us a little bit about yourself first.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. My name is Nasir Mahmood, and currently I'm working as a senior data scientist at Sun Life Insurance Company. As far as my data science or like the journey to Canada is concerned, it basically started in 2004. After doing my master's in computer science, I was basically doing another master's at NUST, Military College of Signals. And at that time, I basically decided to go to Germany in a master's program. So I went to Germany. There I studied like a master program. And after that, I basically did PhD in Germany. And completing PhD, then I basically did a postdoc for 2 years. And then basically, due to like family reasons, we decided to move to Canada, like because we have kids and we thought maybe Canada is a good place to raise your kids. So in 2012, we moved to Canada. And in Canada, basically, my transition was like twofold. First, I was moving to a new country. And second, I wanted to basically move from academia into industry. So I basically struggled for like a few months to get my first job. I was applying at that time, like data science was not a kind of like big news in the industry. No one knew basically there is a data science role. I even knew like in 2013 while reading an article that there is a role called like data science. So I was basically targeting different kinds of jobs like software engineer, C++ developer, because I have been working in C++ for quite long during my research. In the beginning, I find it very hard to land my first job. And now when I basically reflect back, I realize like basically there was some flaws in my strategy. I didn't have like a kind of a mentor because I was a bit shy person because I have been at university. At university, you are mostly interacting with your professor most of the time. And I come from Multan. The people from Multan, they are a bit like shy. And like, I mean, before moving to Germany, like I have visited like Islamabad just like twice to get my visa. Like I haven't basically been out of Multan for like a longer time. So I was talking about like the landing my first job. So I was a shy person. I didn't have like kind of a network or people who can advise me. And secondly, I had like issues with my resume because my resume, my approach, everything was basically set up for like academia jobs, like applying for a postdoc or like a researcher's job. So I was applying like at different positions. I'll get interviews, but afterward, like either they'll say like you are overqualified and other issues. During that time, I even did like a computer repair job for like a month. I was like used to fix like laptops, installing Windows and like replacing laptops screens. So I was used to got paid for like $10 for each computer. So I think I made like $300 in a month. So he was like a Pakistani guy and I came across and he said like, you don't have a job, why you're sitting at home, just come over. So I was used to go there, I'll have a like coffee, chit chat. And he was used to call me, Dr. Saab, could you please fix this computer? So in my opinion, like when you land here, you have like lots of like, if you don't have a job, you are hunting for a job and you have a family, you are going through a kind of like very serious like stress. And if you find this kind of opportunity where you can go and you can do a little bit of work and have a chit chat, so it's a kind of good relief. Like in the evening, you can apply your job to whatever you want to do. But that helped me like in terms of just to basically get out of the house and just go there. After 3 months, I got my kind of internship like through CareerEdge. It's a kind of government back like a agency which helps like newly landed immigrants to find a job. So I got like a three months like a internship contract with American Express in Markham. So I started that. After 2 months, they realized it was a kind of developer job in their infrastructure team. So after 2 months, I think they realized maybe he's a good guy. Then they gave me like a year's contract. And then for a year, I have been working with them like as a programmer or developer in their application infrastructure team. And then after that, there was a kind of discussion around like data science and machine learning. And then the team realized I have a capability in like data science and machine learning. And then they started giving me like projects or like tasks, which were basically data science or like data analysis oriented. So then I worked for like...
So basically that was your entry point. And I think the rest is history in the sense that, okay, then once you made the transition, then it's just basically moving to the next one and the next one. And I guess, as you mentioned, the finding the first opportunity is the difficult one. Beyond that, it gets easier.
So
that's interesting. One more question. You've kind of explained the journey very nicely, Nasir. Thank you so much. One last question, if I could ask you, was if for those people who are just moving to Canada in a similar situation such as yourself, who have done a PhD and trying to transition, what would you advise to them?
So advice, it's hard to say, like, but it really depends on like your situation. Like, for instance, you are coming from Lahore or Islamabad, you have education in Beacon House, Slums, or Ghulam Sa Khan Institute, NUST. You have like 1 or 2 years of experience working with some multinational company, then you are probably a lucky person, you can come here. And then maybe you do like a bit of networking and some like upgrade yourself in terms of resume upgrade and whatever. And then probably you'll get your job. But if you are a person like me coming from Multan who has studied in a Sarkari school and who's a bit shy and he doesn't have like experience in working with any multinational company, so then you have a bit of different like challenges. And on top of the like both situations, on top of both situations, you also have a kind of a factor of luck. Maa ki duaen, jinke aapne dil tode, unki bad duaen, sab kuch mila ke, to you have to face a situation. But it's a nice experience.
No, I think you've kind of summarized things very nicely. Beyond this, of course, there are a lot of things. But yeah. I guess, Nasir, this warrants, of course, longer conversations with you on topics. And I think in follow-up sessions, we will do that. But for today's session, at least, thank you so much for taking the time out. And we will give your LinkedIn in the description, video description. So if there's people who were in a similar situation as yourself and want to reach out, so they can do that.
Yeah, sure. Feel free to reach out to me. I'll be happy to help in whatever way I can help.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Nasir.
Yeah, thank you.